And of course, one of the leading Sydney jockeys, Hugh Bowman.
Hugh Bowman joins me now. Are you enjoying the trip?
Loving it, Graham. It's a working holiday for me. I've enjoyed every minute of being here. The weather's fantastic. The people are very hospitable and it's great.
I know you enjoyed the ball.
Yeah, I did. I had a great time there. I sort of Simon Marshall put me on the spot a little bit, but Darren McCauley interviewed me up in front of everyone. But no, it was a great experience, and everyone up here, it's just such a relaxed atmosphere. Yeah. And, you know, anyone that can ever get here, I recommend it very strongly.
And as you grabbed that mic there on the stage and you started singing with everyone else, it's very good, Hugh. ride better though, mate.
I think as a singer, I'm a very good jockey.
Let's talk about some of your rides. Zillionaire, it's not without a hope. It ran a nice race in the Palmerston on Saturday. It's in the race coming up.
Yeah, Graham, looking through the form, looks to have been in strong sort of lead-up races. I don't have a good grasp on the form line up here, but talking to the boys inside, has got 57, but with the higher weight scale here, I suppose it's the equivalent of 55 in Sydney. I think the horse should run well.
Now, you're right in the cup. You picked up a ride there for Lynn Williams on Past the Vast. It's drawn out wide. It won two starts ago in the Guineas, and it's got into some trouble in the Derby, we hear.
Yeah, apparently it was unlucky in the Derby, but won the Guineas. So again, nice form leading up to the race. Has got 53 on the back. Doesn't look to be a lot of speed in the race, and this horse does go forward. So, you know, it's obviously an on-pace track here on the dirt. I've been told the horse is a little bit of a query at the distance, so I guess I'm just going to have to do the best I can to look after him around the back and hopefully kick clear and win with any luck.
Yeah, your beauty. Scoring up at Gilmore. Speaking of dirt, how do you get that dirt off?
Oh, they've got a bucket of sort of grease soap inside, Graeme. I think you'd have a fit if you saw what you had to do to get it off.
Don't think I'll go and check it out. Welcome to Darwin. I know you've had a great time. You've already had a winner. Good luck in the big race this afternoon, mate.
Thanks very much. Thank you.
Thanks, Graham. Right, they are behind the gates for the next event at Darwin. As you just had a look at the update at Rockhampton. Race 7, Darwin. We have Territory Edition, $6.40. Zillionaire, $8.40. $7.90 for Heart's Treasure. As we have a quick look over. $4.40 for Son of Grace. Number 11, Halifax. Well, it's the favourite at $3.10. Halifax been racing well. Winner last time out at this track in a Class 5 over 1,100 metres. Let's take a break. We'll return with more on Darwin Cup Day after this. Welcome back. Favourite Darwin Race 7 is number 11, Halifax, at $3.10. Shortly they'll be moving up into line. Let's go back for the late mail at Darwin. Here's Graham McNeice.
Well, yes, the late mail here is for Halifax, the favourite. Sheila Arnold, the trainer, David Bates. It's got terrific form up here at Darwin and also at Alice Springs. It's pretty short. Has been support for number 9, Son of Grace. Strongly tipped to defeat the favourite. That's from the Barbara Joseph stable. Heart's Treasure is in the market, number 6, one of two runners that Nev Connor has, the other one being Zillionaire, number 2. And Zillionaire is probably the best back runner late, number 2. But however, number 11 is the late mail here, Halifax, as we head into race number 7 at Darwin.
OK, Graham, Halifax, Hilton Donaldson's late mail in race number 7. The target handicap over 1,300 metres. But moving up into line for the 7th event on the program as we go back out to Mick Stumbles for the call.
Gattaca coming up, but the chances don't stop there. It's a very good race. Palooka to complete the line for the target handicap. Starter about to turn the light on, send them on their way. They look to be all in. 1,300 metres the distance. The light is on and they're ready to run. The little ones playing up badly in the gates. Could be Air Jester. Not too sure from this angle. Light is turned off. A couple of attendants get round the back and one of them is now settled, and the starter satisfied lets them go. Zillionaire threw the head up when the starter said go and missed it badly, and Territory Edition was very slow to get going. Son of Grace came out quickly in company with Gattaca and Palooka out deep. Halifax driving up along the rails behind them, fourth in a lovely spot. A length and a half to Scintillator, starting to go past a couple which are Air Jest to the outside of Basement. A length further back, Rose of Tyrrell caught a little bit deep as Territory Edition and Zillionaire make ground. A length and a half to Heart's Treasure and Starfire Gem, three quarters of a length off last and probably 14 lengths off the lead. Son of Grace in front, down to the 600. A half length to Halifax, so the two popular picks, 1-2 at the moment. Palooka out on the track, three deep is starting to go with that pair. Two or three lengths away, Gattaca under hard riding. Zillionaire coming home well around the outside of Scintillator. Two lengths to Territory Edition. Further back, Heart's Treasure starting to get a bit of a move on from Basement, Starfire Gem, and I think you can safely forget the rest. Down the outside, Palooka is having a go at Son of Grace as they get down by the 200. Halifax can't come on at the moment. Palooka upsides with Son of Grace, 50 to go. Palooka's got his head in front. Son of Grace kicking back the inside. Son of Grace doing a little better than Palooka near home, and Son of Grace will get the money by a half head over Palooka. I think Gattaca the rails has run third, but out deep on the track, Heart's Treasure was a good run, didn't have a lot of luck. Four or five lengths Scintillator from Zillionaire. Further back came Territory Edition. Halifax got very tired with Rose of Tyrrell. She never fired today. Then Basement, Starfire Gem, and Air Jester's racing very poorly. He's last home. Son of Grace will get the decision over Palooka, who I felt at one stage in the straight got his head in front, but Son of Grace would not give up and has come back strongly and more than likely will get it in 115.33. 115.33. Wait for the judge's decision between 9 Son of Grace, 4 Palooka. And there's another couple in there for third, Heart's Treasure. And I can't remember what the other one was now.
Photo here between number 4, which is Palooka, and also number 9, the Barbara Joseph trained Son of Grace. Stand by. Placings are through at Darwin. Yes, number 9, Son of Grace. The Barbara Joseph trained galloper, 4.10, 1.70. Palooka second, a big odds, 12.10. And Heart's Treasure was third, 2.20. They're moving in well at Rockhampton. Let's go. Palooka, Heart's Treasure, 84.90. The Quinella trifecta, $1,705. Let's have a look at the update for the next event at Tatura. First, we are looking here, the concluding stages. Now, the winner is in those yellow and red colours, the Barbara Joseph colours, moving up on the outside. We're trying to look for any interference here. It is second against first. Was a very tight go, was a photo. Number 9, Son of Grace on the inside, and number 4, Palooka on its outer. Very hard to see here without the head on. You might be able to, you can't actually, First looking at that, you would anticipate perhaps that Son of Grace has drifted out, inconveniencing Palooka, but it's very hard to have a look at that without seeing the head on. So we'll leave that one in the steward's room, but there is a protest on, second against first, for alleged interference over the concluding stages. Now Dennis Burke.
The Chief Minister of the Northern Territory, Dennis Burke, joins me now, and Chief Minister, when you see this race day showcased right across Australia, it must make you feel proud to be a Territorian.
Proudly Territorian, while the rest of Australia shivers, Graham. Yeah, a wonderful day and getting better and better every year. And mind you, thanks to Sky too. Sky has been involved with this Darwin Cup since its inception, and we're very proud of the relationship we have.
Delighted to be here, I've got to tell you.
Your family has a background in racing.
My dad was a bookies clerk and a bagman when we were kids growing up. He used to send me out to take some of the runners to find out how the form was down south.
Yeah.
We used to always, we were in Townsville, And we always thought my uncle was rich. He was a bookie because he had 11 phones in his house. I found out later he was a good SP bookie.
It must be gratifying too to see so many of all the people from down south and some of the greats, the likes of Bart Cummings and George Hanlon and Arthur Ward, and all some of the legends of racing coming here each and every year.
And very dependable, come every year, especially Bart. He comes every year. He's very proud of the Darwin Cup. Yeah. He tells us every year what we've got to do to improve it. And we're trying our best to make it a more and more spectacular event. And the interest from the media, the interest from, in fact, this year, I think better field, better horses from down south. So we're doing our best to make it a better and better event.
The racing's great, and you've got a bit of a race on your hands coming up very soon too.
Yeah, but you should stick with the four-legged eggs, mate. The two-legged eggs are no good.
Okay, thanks for that, Graham. Race 9 to Chira, Prince S. Eliza 370. 14 Hey Presto, Frolita 660, Runaway Clip 770, 820 Sir Sphinx and Proven Angel at $11. The protest has been dismissed. The Darwin, 946 numbers as they stand, $84.90 Quinella, Trifecta $1,705. We're now going to go out to Tatura for race number 9. Here's Brian.
Sir Sphinx 740. Hey Presto 420 and Runaway Clip on 830. At odds Jupungle 1420, My Mate Ned 1380 and the Outsider Shanroa on 3450. Now next to move in is Shanroa, Sir Sphinx and Runaway Clip go up. Here's Hey Presto now coming in. So Princess Eliza, Freeleader, Proven Angel, Jupungle to come up. Here's Princess Eliza coming in. Only three to move in for the final event. Tomorrow racing at Mornington on a heavy track. The rail out 6 metres and the first of 9 at 11:50 at Mornington tomorrow. A neat program.